Good morning. Welcome to Pine Island United Methodist Church, where we exist to reach people with God's love, transform lives, and change the world. My name is Kaylee Vita. I'm the pastor here. We are so glad that you're joining us this morning, whether you are worshiping with us here in person or whether you're joining us online this morning. I just have a few announcements. First, we'd love for you to sign those black books that are in the pews. Let us know that you're here this morning. Pass those along to the people beside you. I wanted to pass along an exciting update from our summer movie matinee. We offered an opportunity for people to donate to what we are calling our building fund. And thank you so much to our own Bob Maycomber for getting the word out and inviting his followers. And to all of you who came, we raised just under $1,000 for that building fund. So I wanted to let you all know that this month, we are the recipients of the money from the Bloomin' for Good bouquets of flowers at Winn-Dixie. Sorry, I forgot the name there for a second. Those bouquets are specially marked with that red tag. You can see that on the screen. They're $12.99, but we receive $1 from every bouquet that is purchased, and that comes back directly here to go to our youth food programs, which include both the pilot after-school program, the meals that they provide for students, and our backpack program that sends home those food bags with the Pine Island Elementary students on Fridays. We do have a leadership team meeting this Tuesday night. It'll be over in the office building in rooms 1 and 2. Everyone is invited to attend. Those meetings are open. So if you are interested in finding out more about what's happening here at the church, or you even just have some questions and you'd like to see if you get it answered, or you'd like to ask those questions, you're invited to attend those meetings. Pilot started back this week. They've officially completed 1 week of the school year, so that was exciting. They are meeting 4 days a week this year, Monday through Thursday. They're here from 3:30 to 6:30, you can see on the screen that they need some volunteers. So if you have any interest at all in helping with driving, sitting with some kids and reading with them and helping them with their homework, and by help, we mean just encourage them to keep working. You don't have to completely understand any hard math to sit with them. You could help Paul with making and serving some food, and I'm sure there are a plethora of other things that they can find for you to do. So if you have any interest at all in helping with that program, see Paul today after the service. And now will you pray with me? Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come and fill this place today. Open our hearts and our minds as we worship, praise, and listen. Thank you for the opportunity we have to come together today. We offer our worship as a gift to you. Amen.
Now that you've made it in from the parking lot, found your seat, and sat down, let's stand and start the day with song.
I will lift up.
throne.
Eyes to the throne.
I will trust you.
I will trust you.
Trust you alone.
You alone.
I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy of my praise. I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone are worthy of my praise.
Yeah. Yeah, great. They follow well.
Indeed.
Short. We can do that again. Let's do it again.
Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you.
Be seated, and we'll invite the kids up.
Here they come. Hi. Hello, children. Did any of you have to make a choice this morning? Like what to wear, what to eat? Yeah? We have to make a lot of choices every day, even when we don't think about it. Have any of you had to make a difficult choice?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That can be really hard. Well, today's story talks about a man who made a pretty interesting choice. This man, we can call him Jeremy, was going to lose his job. Instead of being upset and just leaving normally, he did something else. See, a lot of people owed his boss money. But Jeremy knew that these people would never be able to pay back his boss. So he told them that they didn't have to pay as much. Because he did this good thing for them, those people would later want to be friends with Jeremy, and they might even offer him help after he lost his job. Well, we can do something kind of like that too. When we make the choice to do something good instead of what's easy, God will reward us. Maybe not with something we might want right now, like toys or money, but he'll make sure that we always have what we need. And if we keep making these good decisions, someday he'll even let us into heaven. I don't know about you, but that seems pretty great. Today's letter is A. Does everybody see what A looks like? Does anyone know what that might stand for? Any ideas?
Abracadabra.
Abracadabra? It's a good guess. Anyone else? Amazing. That's a good guess. Amen. Pretty good guess as well. Those are all great guesses. But today, it stands for active. Because we have to make the active decision to do the right thing for God. Now let's pray. Dear God, thank you for giving us this opportunity. Help us to remember to do the right thing, even when it's hard. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now let's go to the nursery.
Good morning, all. Bow our heads in prayer, please. Good morning, God. We come to you this day to worship you and praise your name. Your blessings are abundant. You surround us with so much. If only we would just take the time to actually look for them, we would be amazed and sometimes even astonished by the number of blessings you have given to us all. Our thanks and gratitude are sometimes delayed. But we are noticing them, dear Lord, though sometimes not until the end of the day or week, or even sometimes longer than that. So help us to be aware more frequently of all your gifts that you have given and bestowed upon us. But right now, we want to take the time to say, thank you, Lord. This morning, we also want to praise your name as a gathering of your people by singing and rejoicing and worshiping your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We also choose this moment today to focus our thoughts and prayers and presence on you, O Lord. Teach us and lead us in your word and how also to live our lives to be more like your Son, Jesus. It is in his blessed name that we offer this prayer together, the prayer your Son taught us by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as earth as we did in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Please join us and singing, I'm gonna live so God can use me. you're going to want to stand. I'm going to live so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm going to live so God can use me anywhere, anytime. I'm going to work so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm going to work so God can use me anywhere, anytime. I'm going to pray so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm going to pray so God can use me anywhere, anytime. I'm gonna sing so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna sing so God can use me anywhere, anytime, anywhere, anytime.
Well, that was fun. As our ushers prepare to come and serve us today, I'd like to thank you again for your generosity. It is because of you being a generous people, all of us being a generous people, that we can provide a program like Pilot, that after-school program, that creating Pine Island Leaders of Tomorrow. And I want to thank you for that and for the difference that that's making in the lives of all of the kids that come here every week. God, in Jesus Christ, has given us much to be faithful for. Our tithes, gifts, and offerings may seem little in comparison to God's gift to us. But we are called to be faithful over all that we have, our time, our talents, our gifts, and our service. When we give of ourselves, we practice the spiritual discipline of stewardship. And when we are faithful over a few things in this life, in the life to come, we may be faithful over much, much more. May God bless us in our giving, that God's kingdom may be here with us on earth. Amen.
please stand. Join us.
We bring sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of thanksgiving. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of joy.
Maybe seated.
Today's scripture reading is from the book of Luke, chapter 16, 1 through 13. Then Jesus said to the disciples, "There was a rich man who had a manager, and charges were brought to him that this man was squandering his property. So he summoned him and said to him, 'What is this that I hear about you? Give me an accounting of your management, because you cannot be my manager any longer.' Then the manager said to himself, 'What will I do? Now that my master is taking the position away from me, I am not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. I have decided what to do so that when I am dismissed as manager, people may welcome me into their homes.' So, summoning his master's debtors one by one, he asked the first, 'How much do you owe my master?' He answered, 100 jugs of olive oil. He said to him, 'Take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it 50. Then he asked another, "And how much do you owe?" He replied, 100 containers of wheat. He said to him, 'Take your bill and make it 80. And his master commended the dishonest manager because he had acted shrewdly. For the children of this age are more shrewd in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into the eternal homes. Whoever is faithful in a very little is faithful also in much. And whoever is dishonest in a very little is dishonest also in much. If then you have not been faithful with a dishonest wealth, who will entrust you the true riches? And if you have not been faithful what belongs to another, who will give you what is your own? No slave can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Well, thank you, Bob, for reading our scripture today, and thank you, Shelley, for praying for us this morning, too. Now, for those of you who don't know, maybe Bob and Shelley are married. Bob is our chair of trustees, and Shelley is currently our chair of SPRC and finance. The finance was an ad earlier this summer, and I'm going to brag on them for a second. They didn't know I was going to do this, so don't turn too red, you guys, but as a United Methodist, when you become a member of the church, you vow to give of your time, your talents, your gifts, your service, and your witness. Now, these two people, they live into those vows fully and wholeheartedly. They spend a whole lot of their time here each week, not out of obligation, but out of service and love for this community. Now, there are many others of you sitting in these pews that do the very same thing, but because they were both part of our service today, I wanted to take this moment and recognize them. So be sure to thank them today for all that they do for this place when you see them after the service. And thank you to all of you who do that, all of you. There are so many of you who give so much to this place, so... Our series, Having Words with Jesus, is not an easy one. is it? Now, first we studied the difficult passage about what it means to make Jesus the priority in our life, putting him above everyone and everything else. He must be the most important person in our lives. And then last week, we discovered that there is work to be done. We, like the sheep owner and the woman, must search diligently for what is lost. Our community is not complete until everyone is present. There's great rejoicing when those who are lost or aren't present are brought into the fold where they belong. We live as rejoicing people, celebrating that we have been found, we have been brought in, but we also at the same time live with the knowing that there is more we need to do, more who need to be brought in, who need to find their place of belonging. We must keep searching. Well, this week, we turn to perhaps one of, if not the most difficult of parables that Jesus tells. Outrageous, even. Jesus actually says, make friends by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into eternal homes. Now, that is most certainly not one of the top 10 verses to memorize, is it? Now, is Jesus suggesting we be dishonest? Is this shrewd manager to be an example for us? No. And yes, it's complicated, which we already know. That's why the parable is in this series of difficult teachings of Jesus. There was a rich man who had a manager. Now, the rich man is concerned with one thing, so it seems, money, getting richer. He's gotten word that this manager of his is wasting his possessions. Without asking the manager if it's true or for an explanation, the rich man just fires the manager, asking for an accounting of his management. Now, the manager knows he's going to be out of work as soon as he turns in that paperwork. What is he going to do? He most likely won't be hired as a manager for another rich man. That ship has sailed. He won't last digging, and, well, he has too much pride to beg. But what he does still have in his possession is the accounts of the rich man's debtors. So he makes the decision to use what he has in the present to secure his future. He's actually being a good manager. The art of management, after all, is using what you have today to get what you want in the future. In order to be where he wanted to be in the future, that manager knew that how he handled today mattered. He was going to need friends in the future, people to help him out, give him a good reference for a new job. So he goes to those in debt, asks them how much they owe, and then tells them to change it, reducing their debt. Now, we could get into a discussion here about what this manager has done. He's being dishonest. He's cheating his boss out of what is owed him. He's encouraging lying. Now, some say that it's possible that the rich man had inflated what was owed him, so it wasn't really hurting him that much. Others say that the manager would have gotten a commission on what he collected. So perhaps he reduced the debts by the amount of his commission, meaning that he was acting generously, giving up his own portion. But that doesn't seem to be the point that Jesus is trying to make. You see, the manager is commended by his boss because he acted shrewdly. It's his shrewdness that is central in this story, not his dishonesty. The Greek word used for shrewdly is phronimos. It means prudent or wise. Now, too often we think of shrewd with some negative connotations. Jesus uses it here, as well as in Matthew, positively. In Matthew 10:16, Jesus has just given the disciples their instructions as they're being sent out. And he says, "Look, I am sending you out as sheep among wolves. So be shrewd as snakes and harmless as doves." Disciples are to be shrewd, prudent, wise. This manager in our story, he has some foresight. He's being pragmatic. And Jesus applies this principle from the parable to real life. He says that children of this age, meaning unbelievers, are more shrewd or wise in dealing with things of this world than our children of light, who are believers, in dealing with the world to come. Now, this shrewd manager knew exactly what to do in order to have what he needed in the future. Well, what does this have to do with believers being wise about the life to come? That's where verse 9 comes in, that one that isn't found on any top 10 lists of verses to memorize. Jesus says, "And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into the eternal homes." Now, dishonest wealth doesn't mean shady business or illegal transactions. Actually, it's the money we carry in our pockets, the money we put in the offering plate. For Jesus, it was the money of the empire. It's the money of a world that is passing, making way for a new way of living. Dishonest wealth is that which is indebted to the way things are in a broken and sinful world. And Jesus says, use it. Use it for the kingdom of God. Use it for the purposes for which it wasn't created. Use it to build community and to value people. Use it to rescue people rather than to enslave them. Use it to lift people up, not push them down. Use it to give away and not to hoard. Jesus isn't saying earn wealth inappropriately. The only laws that he's telling us to break are the ones that the world carries about money. Get all you can, no matter who gets hurt. Measure your value by how much you have. Always desire more. Instead, Jesus says, live by God's laws. Love God and love neighbor, even if it costs you something. In the words of our United Methodist founder, John Wesley, earn all you can, save all you can, and give all you can. Don't use money the way it is usually used. In this way, then you will make friends who will one day welcome you into eternal homes. Because in God's economy, relationships are valued over riches. Which begs the question, how are you using your money? Now, the shrewd manager in our story today, he used what he had to build relationships so his future would be secure, his immediate future. But our concern is our eternal future. So how are we using our money? We all need to stop and ask ourselves, is my money serving God, or am I using God to build my money? Is money the means to an end, or has it become the end? Is my goal to serve both God and others with my money and wealth, or has the goal become simply to earn more? Now, these are important questions to consider in light of the end of this story. Not part of the parable, we find ourselves reading a series of sayings of Jesus, explaining the process of living in this world and working for the kingdom at the same time. It won't be easy, so Jesus tells us, take small steps. Learn to be faithful in the small things, the daily things, the quickly forgotten and passed by things. Life, after all, consists of many small things strung together. A chance to offer a cup of water, to teach a Sunday school class, write a note, share a meal, tell a child a story, go to choir practice, feed the neighbor's cat. Be faithful in these things. Then the big things, relationships and family and home and joy and peace and justice will be yours as well. Be faithful with the wealth of the world, using it to serve God. And then true riches, responsibilities in God's kingdom will be yours as well. Be faithful with other people's things. Then you'll be entrusted with your own. Because, and this is the clincher of the whole thing, no one can serve two masters. You will hate one and love the other, be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth. Our call as Jesus' disciples is to live in this world with God as our master. Our job is to be faithful, shrewd managers, wise, prudent, pragmatic disciples who use what we are given to love God and to love our neighbors. Now, last week we talked about lost things, lost sheep, lost coins. We talked about having a job to do, to search for those who are lost, who aren't here. We must not forget to count. We must find those who are missing so they can be brought into the fold where they belong, where they have a place. But this week, we've discovered why this task is so important. Because in God's economy, relationships matter more than riches. God's economy has little to do with fairness or keeping proper ledgers. It isn't about hoarding all you can or only looking out for ourselves. God's economy is about reconciliation and forgiveness. It's about grace and freedom. Being set free from the ways of the world in order to live in the ways of God. The shrewd manager, he set himself free from the constraints of wealth when he put relationships at the forefront. We do the same when we choose Jesus. When we choose to live according to God's economy, putting relationships before wealth, using our money to serve God, earning all we can, saving all we can, giving all we can. Will you pray with me? This was a hard one today, Jesus. We want to be good and faithful stewards. We want to manage the gifts we have been given well, to serve you and love our neighbor. We confess it is hard. The world tells us to hold on to what we have. Today we hear you telling us that your way is not the world's way. Your way is generosity. Your way is relationship. We know and trust that your way is better. Practicing small things, being faithful in those each and every day, leads to our eternal future. Thank you for your grace and mercy that forgives us, that offers us a new start, that never turns us away, even when we mess up and forget. It is truly amazing. We love you because you first loved us. Amen.
Stand and sing with me. grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. T'was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, ransomed me. Mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secures. He shield and portions be as long as life endures. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, ransom me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns. Amazing grace.
My prayer for you this week is that you will be a shrewd manager, a wise disciple as you live your life, faithful in the small things, wise with what you've been giving, using them to serve God and to serve your neighbors. Amen.
The earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine. But God, who calls me here below, He will be forever mine. My chains are gone. My Savior, ransom me, and like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. My chains are gone, I've been set free, my God, my Savior. Amazing grace, unending love, amazing grace.
Yeah. Thanks. It was great worshiping with you, dude. We'll see you again next week. Go in peace.